win and we learn, and sometimes we even enjoy the memories of our misbehavior. And no one else has got to admit that shit aloud, by the way. So best believe there are times where I heartily enjoyed, say, sex on the first night, and the overall exploration and satiation of my sexual appetite, to a degree that I was comfortable with, of course. However, my memory also includes some moments where certain parts of my body were being loaned to the wrong men, and not wrong to necessarily mean bad, but wrong meaning not right. And as I grew more settled into my life as a single adult woman, I realize now that although I do enjoy connection and attention, I was overlooking this craving I had for love. And because delayed gratification can be a hell of a bitch, I was still reaching for a couple plates at the lust buffet. Why? Because it was an accessible way to feed my lonely ass during times of need. But then I realized that last part of being fed was becoming more and more of a falsehood, because I was actually rather empty and watching myself reach for the thrill of cheap validation even after the fun had expired. And so I finally stopped stalling this epiphany and just let it come barreling down. And I realized that I was pathetic. Nah, I'm human. I'm never freaking pathetic. What I realized is that I needed to turn the volume down on my flesh so that I could clearly hear my spirit. And let me point this out to y'all. Our flesh and our spirit, they both want the same thing, to feel wanted. But they want it through different means and with different costs. So this is what my spirit told me. Tracy, baby girl, we can call you a self-aware soul. That's dope. You're completely comfortable with your 12-man body count. Good for you, girl. But that does not exempt you from graduating to a higher level where you gotta put in some harder work. And my spirit didn't stop there. Because you see, once your spirit knows that you can recognize its voice, man, does it not stop yapping. So I'm also hearing it's time to be patient. It's time to set and honor your standards. It's time to gate your temple a bit so that you truly understand that real solitude won't kill you as a woman, but rather build you. It's time to cool out on Pornhub.com and pass on that extra shot of troublemaking tequila. It's time to explore neglected levels of intimacy with your family and friends. And it's time to really figure out what this self-love shit is all about so that you can begin to attract a new kind of